So we're back from our lunch. Well, you're not back from your lunch. I know that for sure. You are still on lunch, but you are with me. Let me say good afternoon to all of you joining me on YouTube. Good afternoon. And all of you joining me on Facebook. Good afternoon. Thanks very much for being a part of Constructive Talk today. And I just wanted to show you a video. So I wanted to show you two videos. Yeah. And after the two videos, I wanted to open up the phone lines and allow you to weigh into the discussion that we're about to have today. So I was telling you before we went to the news that I'm a little, you always hear people saying, you know, Trinidad is not a real place. Trinidad is not a real world. And you hear people making comments about statements that things that are happening that you wonder, oh my goodness, is this really happening in Trinidad and Tobago? So let me show you this video. So you have to come on the live to see this video. Someone attempting to drive up a walkover. Now, when you see it, you're going to be really shocked. You're going to be taken aback. You're going to be wondering, what kind of mad thing is that? That is in Trinidad? No, that can't be Trinidad. That's somewhere out of Trinidad and Tobago. That's not Trinidad and Tobago. You're left spreading fake news. That has to be outside of Trinidad and Tobago. So join me on the live and look at this. Where this vehicle ended up. When I got the video, I called the person who sent the video for me and I asked them, I said, this is Trinidad, you're sure? I don't want to show nothing or talk about anything. You know, I don't want to show anything or talk about anything that is not real. So the person said to me, no, it's real. Totally real. Right here. Trinidad and Tobago. I'm on the side. He wants to not walk up the walkover, but drive up a walkover. Or a walk. Yeah, a walk. Lord, Father. So, this is the video. I'm going to show you the video now. I don't know why I'm not seeing. This is strange. Alright, but alright, so let me show you the video. When you see this video, you're going to be really... All right, somebody's telling me that Facebook is down. All right. Okay, let me see what's happening here. Okay, so I'm going to... For those of you who are looking for me on Facebook, I'm going to do over Facebook so that you can see me on Facebook. All right, so I know a lot of you might be looking for me on Facebook. So let me send you back over on Facebook. Because I don't know, I am seeing me here on Facebook, but apparently you all are not seeing me on Facebook. All right, so I'm gonna do over Facebook so that you all could come and join me on Facebook. Cool? So those of you who are looking for me on Facebook, you're going to see me on Facebook in a short bit. All right? You will see me on Facebook in a short bit. Yes, so this gentleman decided that he's not going to walk over the walkover. He is going to drive his vehicle over the walkover. Now, tell you, when I saw it, I was really taken aback. I was shocked. I said, no way, Jose. This could never be real. This was Photoshop. Somebody playing games and decide that they're going to do. But then it was a video. Right? It was a video. It was not a picture. It's a video. So when I saw the video, I said, nah, man. So let me say good morning again to 231 persons who are jumping on YouTube. Good morning to you guys. Well, good afternoon to you guys. And to my Facebook people, I know you're going to come on now. So I'm going to show the video. As you all come on, you're going to see the video. To all my Facebook people, good afternoon again. And thank you to all my YouTubers who are locked on to the Street 919 FM. So, I'm going to the video though. This look like it is by... Where, boy? Anybody, let me see if anybody can tell me where this walkover is. Anybody can tell me where this walkover is. Alright? So this is the video. How you reach there? That is. How you reach there? That's my question. How you reach here? Look at the video, you know. How you end up there? That's the question. That's the big question, you know. How you end up there? I am lost. I am lost for words. When I saw this video, I was lost for words. How did you end up there? This is a walkover by the Diwali Nagar. Right? It's a walk over. How this vehicle end up on the walkover? Huh? How? Anybody could tell me? Anybody want to attempt to tell me how this vehicle reached here? This is a real shocker for me. Real, real shocker. So I just had to show you that. Right? Nah, man, Trinidad people, for real, seriously, that has to be some... No, it's real. When I saw it first, I saw it like this. I saw the picture. And I said to myself, somebody did a very good Photoshop of this picture. Right? And then I got the video. And when I saw the video, then I said to myself, wow, no, this is a video. And this is a real situation that took place. All right? Real, real situation that took place. So right now in Trinidad and Tobago, taxis, maxis, the Prime Minister would have made his announcement. And he said that taxis, maxis, public transport can go back to 100% capacity. All right? That's what he said. He said that Trinidad and Tobago, we are opening back up. It's no longer a pandemic. It's an endemic. And we're going back to 100% where transport is concerned. So the question was asked, the big question was asked, that some people are saying, some people are asking if some of the public transport are going to reduce their price. One taxi driver, or one maxi driver, I should say, from Digo Martin, the Yellow Band, I believe he's the president, would have said that they are not going to drop back down their price because they don't think it is feasible to do so. Other taxi drivers and maxi drivers are saying that gas has gone up, cost of living is high, and stuff like that. So, people are asking, were they fooled by maxis and taxi drivers? Some taxi drivers would have said, when the pandemic is over and they go back to their 100% capacity, they will carry back down the price. And we're seeing where this discussion is happening, and some taxi drivers are adamant that they're not going to take down the price. All right. So that is one of the discussions that are happening in the public domain, where taxi drivers and maxi drivers are concerned. The other discussion that is happening in the public domain is about the issue concerning, I'm seeing two associations, Principals Association, and some other association is saying that the SCA students are not ready for SCA. While they were at home, one school was saying that while they were at home, the children were performing better. One school was, or one association was saying that, and they are national winner, national, you know, that school always top the mark where SCA is concerned. And the school is saying, the association is saying, the principal association is saying that the children at that school were doing better online for SCA than in the classroom. And they're asking for two options: go back to the online or push back the date for the exam. So I wanted to hear your views on those two topics. And boy, oh boy, right? Some people are saying that while we were in lockdown for the 2 years, we should have looked at replacing or getting rid of the C exam. Some people are saying that we could have used the two options of looking at how things are going, where some children perform better when you give them extended time, and some children are ready despite whatever time you give. And we should have looked into all of those things. Interesting conversation. But I am looking at the schools that are calling on the ministry to send the SCA students back home, to go back online, because they were performing better online. All right? What are your views about that? And what are your views about taxi drivers? Or I don't know, I would have to do some flashback and find, get the videos of some taxis, some taxi drivers association saying that when the pandemic is over, they will reduce back the price. But now they're saying that they can't because gas prices has gone up and cost of living has gone up. All right, so we go into the phone lines. I want to hear your views on the issues that I'm talking about. I'm really not into the discussing any other views because I really can't handle the, you know what I mean? Hello, good afternoon.
Afternoon, Mr. Papaji. The listeners, but I'll comment on two issues. The first one, with the vehicle on the walkover, Papaji, died Dr. Rowley Paul. Died the PNM Paul, somehow it was zero back to them. But on the SCA issue, Papaji, I have a state where, you know, I'll tell you something. We need to be innovative at this point in time. I want to say to parents, I want to say to teachers, you know, we can't keep complaining and the government has to do this and back down and send back to remote. All I am saying is this, that I find the teachers should take the students, discuss the syllabus, discuss the curriculum in the syllabus, and, you know, probably give them copies of it and say, all right, at the end of the term, this is what we had to teach earlier, this is what they had to know at the end of the term, and browse through the whole syllabus in terms of our orientation to children. And and in that way, you're ready, the children might be on their teenage children. I kind of put up, Papaji, at the approach, the people responsible, like tutor and people who are the head of education in terms of how they keep, you know, so look at, how, is it the denominational schools calling for that? No. The denominational schools just do what they have to do with very little resources and they get magnanimous results. And I find it's time for us to change our attitude in terms of what we're saying and how we want to approach education. So all I'm saying to teachers, if all you're listening, bring the children in on all your objectives to the end of the term. Let them know what you want to do. Give them a little brochure to the syllabus. Give them a little brochure over the curriculum and having the syllabus. And this will help progress forward. I find most times we're too regressive in our thinking as far as education is concerned. Thank you, Father Chief.
All right, thank you. Hello, good afternoon.
Afternoon, sir. As long as there are people who walk away, that's what I'm saying. There are more people. Each time they want to drop off into another people, I'm blown black candle, more going to happen. No call for it.
Okay, thank you very much. All right, so the number is to call at 342-0081 and 466-5391. So we're looking at the SEA exams, people saying that the children are not ready. Some people are saying that, not everyone is saying that. Hello, good afternoon.
Yes, hello, good afternoon, Pastor Google. No, Mr. Manon is really right, you know. It's really hard to run this country, you know. Damn if you do, damn if you don't. I recall last year that when government proposed online schooling for children, I think the certain section of the teacher and was against it, particularly tutor. Right? And this is due to the COVID situation. Now that things has kind of eased up a little, we're in a different tune. So I'm a little confused. I thought this would be good news, but apparently certain people, I understand that with the COVID situation, yes, but we're trying to resume some kind of normalcy in the country. And with respect to the situation with the high fares, you really, Pastor Google, you really believe that the maxis and taxis people will drop their fares? Do you really believe that, Pastor Google? in this country. But like I said again, if you could go back to the archive and see what the taxi driver will say, well, it will just show that there's a bunch of hypocrisy. Right? But like I said again, I wouldn't see any drop in fares in the foreseeable future. So those guys have a good excuse. You have a good day, Pastor Google.
All right, thank you very much. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Pastor Google.
Good afternoon.
Pastor Google, based on your question, I'm saying that it's only one set of people get the children ready. Homeschooling teachers and the educational teacher paid for by taxpayer. You are made to get the children prepared for the exam. So if they're not ready, it means that you did not get them ready. You did not teach them well to make them ready. Whatever you teach them for that exam, because, you know, they are preparing for that exam when they reach a certain standard, right? And that's all they're doing, preparing them to continue to do the exam and also to continue. So if they're not prepared, you, the teachers, have not prepared them. I would like to talk on something else, but another time later on. Have a good day.
Okay, thank you very much. Hello, good afternoon.
Hi, Pastor Google. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Pastor Google, well, it's really not concerning, but it's over the highway here. They built a community center in the Savannah, and now they're vandalizing the community center. I don't know what you could do about that.
Okay.
Hello?
Okay.
Hello?
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Okay, Pastor. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, then. So we're taking your calls. We're looking at the schools, the children ready. If you believe that the children are ready for SEA, if you're a parent and you're listening and you want to call in, share your views based on information coming out about, you know, there's a school organization that is saying that the children were doing well online, and now that they have brought them out, they're realizing that the children are not making the marks that would allow them to go to the schools of their choice. So some parents and, you know, some principals, teachers from I don't want to call the name of the school or the schools, but they're saying that their children are doing better online, and they were asking for the government to consider allowing them to go back to online for 3 weeks before the exams to get their children back at that place where they were able to reach the marks of to pass to the schools of their choice. All right? That is one of the discussions that I'm having. Also, where the taxi drivers are concerned, maxi taxi drivers are concerned, maxi taxi drivers are saying that they cannot go back to, they can't reduce the fare. Sorry, they're not reducing it. Cost of living has gone up, and different things. It can't reduce the fare. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Pastor Will.
Hi, good afternoon.
You hear me? You're a genius, you know. You're a genius. You know why you're a genius? The teachers and the principal and them, they want to send children in the school of their choice. They don't care about common entrance and thing. They want to send children them in the children them up in school of them choice. That's what the people want. They fight just to be the learning and thing. They want to send the children in their choice. Where they say goes, and that's where they get in trouble with. Bye bye.
Okay. Hello. Good afternoon.
So good evening to you, Pastor Google.
Good afternoon, sir.
And good evening to Miss Muruga. And Pastor Google, there's an agenda in this country, right? Because 1 minute we are saying that we want the children back out of school. And when the authorities are doing everything impossible to get the children back out of school, it's a whole set of games with these union and with these people who continue not putting country first, but putting politics and dividing this country. Because, Pastor Google, the children need to go back in physical school. I am supporting it 100%. You know what I mean? The world are living with this virus. It's not like a virus with AIDS and things. You have to live with it for the next so much years, we do not know. But you have to live with it, anything. So we have to be very concerned about having this proposition, because people will go haywire and do not understand that the children mentally is being hurt. Because first of all, I know about post primary, I know about son of five, I know about school, I know where I grew up. I mean, yes, we know that technology is there and it's here to stay. Nobody come to move it, but it's there. So it seems that, because look at that, my brother, today I want to thank the government personally for sending back out all the public servants out there. I hope that it can report that first staff was out there. And the union was pushing that. Lady workers and them, they'll come out to work. Why are you keeping them home? And you know now, this again is not about country. They cannot tell Kingsley joining no PNM go along gang together with a wrongly. It's not about country. I just do not want to remove a man and ask myself what next after. Because today, Kamala Prasad, Mr. Sa, have no plans to govern this country. Because you cannot tell me you govern this country by saying how much house we already have. That is what I am going to vote for, Pastor Google. If you want to vote for that, it's okay. What is the policy? I am not going to vote for much children that already have or much outside the children have. Then I'm not concerned. What is Kamala Prasad, Mr. Sa, policy on education? That is my concern. Don't tell me about Rowdy, have a wife here and a child here. No, we big people and we human beings. But what I'm saying, if we're speaking about constitution reform, the local reform, changing laws and things in the country, I am for that. But I am not to remove no minister of education. I'm not and what next? I am not about moving no minister of energy. That will solve anything. Said no. Google, we have to be focused. And we have to send the message. And that is why I do not know why PNM build a base of grassroots people that today, that social media, they can have a body on social media, a body on radio, a body on TV, sending out the message, because I want to see this brave that the PNM supporters, because they know I am not a PNM supporter. I am not. But the PNM supporter and the PNM talk shows, activists, and presenters, fighting more hard than Dr. Rowdy, fighting more hard than Penny, fighting more hard than Brown. These PNM, when they hear them calling on your station, when they hear them on the ground, when they hear Mr. Ford of Spain, when they hear Bataria, when they hear Ronald Jr., Pastor Google, Aisha West, Sean Felix, these are the people is who are holding up the flag. Pastor Google come every day, he gets cussed. They make a video with him because he loves the country, he loves the God. I mean, and when you could see that the UNC today have a Facebook team, they have a radio team, they have a TV present team. Pastor Google, the UNC own social media more. They have more people on social media sending out the wrong message, putting the wrong image of the for people to see, and the PNM needs to take a matter. I do not know who the person to go to. A person, somebody that the PNM activists, the PNM talk show host could go to, that they could get the problem solved. And today, I am asking questions still as an independent person, as Dr. Rowdy said, as the chairman of the PNM said, that Dr. Rowdy ain't going nowhere, as the PNM council meeting take place yesterday at Bally's House. Anybody say that Dr. Rowdy is going back up, he ain't going nowhere. I am asking, what is the plan to move forward? Because it wouldn't be the PNM winning by an easy fight. It's going to be a fight because a party is coming into Trinidad and Tobago. And if PNM ends setting the ground right, because Google, I want to thank you as always, because so much to say, I'm not getting emotional and spirit movement because I'm hurting inside there. Father Google, I thank you very much. My brother.
Know if you was in India walk Saturday. I wanted to come, but the rain keep on coming and stopping. But Pastor Google, some people say Trinidad is not a real place. Who is the people that making this place not a real place? Huh? I sure if Miss Kamala B. Sasa Prasad hear about this guy go driving over the walkover, she will say he doing the right thing. Okay? And she will find some fault, something that the government didn't do, so that's why he driving over the walkway. Okay? To come up against anything in this country, to bring law against anything that is happening, to make this place a better place, you cannot do it while Kamala them is in power. And people of this country all of what you all are doing and stop picking these people to be the opposition. Time to remove these people. They will make you lose your train. They will make people lose their life. All kind of thing they're doing to this country. I had to cut it because I know it doesn't play a long video. So.
All right, hello, good afternoon.
Hi, hello.
Yes, sir. Hello? Hello? Caller. All right, you have to call me back. All right. I want to touch on the issue, but I will leave that alone. I'll leave that alone. Hello, good afternoon.
Hi, I'm in touch.
I am cool.
Okay. Hello.
Hello. I don't know what's happening with your phone, but you're breaking up really badly, and the call is not coming through. All right? I don't know if you want to try me on the other number, but I'm not hearing you clearly, and you're not coming through at all. So I think you need to call me back. All right? Let's see how short this voice note is.
Pastor, good morning, sir. I fell up on them, PNM supporter, them only blaming Kamala, right through Kamala, nothing, Baba. It's the PNM in power, PNM in charge. PNM playing mad.
Okay, PNM playing mad. I hear you, sir. So we come back from the break, I'm going to play the rest of voice notes that they are. And then I'm going to switch gears into a discussion. I'm going to come back into talking about something that I think you all want to hear about also. Kingsley would have touched on it, but I'm going to get some proper information on it and share it with you guys. When I come back, we're going to talk a little bit about that. Don't touch your dial. Stay right here on the Street 919 FM.
Is it all right if I give you some Caribbean reggae music? Worship this afternoon. Well, everybody just dance with you right now. We are to magnify the name of Jesus. The song goes like this. Watch it. Look. So we send and lift up our hands. Hey, for the joy of the Lord is my strength. So we bow down, worshiping now. How great, how awesome is it? Everybody help me say, we say, say. So we say, give us some music again, please, now. Right now where you are, in your homes, just begin to worship the name of Jesus. So we send and lift up our hands. Lift it up. For the joy of the Lord is our strength. We bow down and worship Him now. How great and awesome is everybody help me say.
We bow down and worship. Every Friday between 3 to 4 p.m. right here on the street, 919 FM, radio you can see. Log on to our Facebook and YouTube so you can see live interviews and performances from some of our very own local superstars. Right here on the street, 919 FM. At New City Malls and check out our premium selection of high quality clothing and accessories for men and women. Save on all items with competitive prices and courteous service throughout the entire mall. New City Mall is located in the heart of Port of Spain with entrances at 3 Charlotte Street and number 41 Independence Square. We offer a variety of shirts, long and short sleeve, round and V-neck tops, vests, caps, hats, sunglasses, briefs, boxers, shorts, swim trunks, denim, jeans, long and three quarters, socks, sneakers, casual and athletic, shoes, dressy and fashionable, dresses, formal and casual, skirts, lingerie, undergarments, and a wide range of accessories. Come check us out, as we also have clothing and accessories like Levi's, Clarks, Armani Exchange, Hollister, American Eagle, Ralph Lauren, Nike Air Force and Air Max, Puma, Adidas, Timberland, Academics, Aeropostale, Old Navy, Forever 21, Hanes, Dockers, Guess, Converse, and so much more. We have barbers, hairstylists, as well as weave and wigs on sale. All at New City Mall. Like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram. Sale, sale, sale.
Tune into the street 919 FM this and every Thursday for the program Conscious Talk.
Conscious Talk.
Where we are at and where we are going with Steve Antoine as regards to land space for the celebration of Emancipation Day. Every Thursday from 10:25 a.m. to 10:55 a.m. It's Conscious Talk on the street 919 FM.
Every Friday, it's all about Firewood Soccer Fridays with MC Dukan Selector Kochi from 6 straight to 9 p.m. blazing all the latest and past soccer hits. So remember, make it a line, make it a day, rock and come in. It's all about Firewood Soccer Fridays on the Street 919 FM. Don't know.
Do you need a business consultation? Would you like to learn about investing? Maybe. You were looking for investment opportunities. Well, Learn Capital Certificates is the company you've been looking for. We're located at number 9 to 11 Fitch Street South, Woodbrook, and our contact number is 324-LEN. That's 324-LENN. Get in touch with us today and we can help you grow your business, make better financial decisions, and enable you to earn a passive income. Feel free to ask about our precious gem packages. But remember, at Learn Capital Certificates, it's all about you.
If you're experiencing pain, constipation, headaches, poor blood circulation, high or low blood pressure, diabetes, cancer, swollen or darkened feet, come visit us at Health and Wealth Lifestyle, located at 73 Eastern Main Road, Barataria, opposite Eastern Credit Union. We at Health and Wealth Lifestyle offer a wide range of services. Come and experience our new 3D analyzer, which allows you to have a look inside your body. We also provide live blood analysis, iridology, ionic foot detox with foot soak and foot massage, aquatherapy, full body massage, and organic supplements on sale such as Nano Silver, Nano Zinc, Body Light, Cold Pressed Sesame Oil, and more. Health and Wealth Lifestyle, located at number 73 Eastern Main Road, Barataria, opposite Eastern Credit Union. For more information, call 275-8359 or 288-1108. Join Nicole Huggins for Health and Wealth Lifestyle every Monday from 9:05 a.m. to 9:55 a.m. right here on the street, 919 FM.
Turn your lights down low and listen to the Master's Radio.
The Church of the Firstborn Assembly of Numbers 399 Eastern Main Road, Kwaiko Sangwe Grandi, is pleased to present Pastors Morris and Agnes Johnson and guest. Sundays, Tuesdays, and Friday night, Sunday Ministry of Worship, Children Hour, and the Word from 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. Tuesdays, see Jesus in every book of the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. Tuesday morning from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. And Friday night, 9 p.m. to 5 a.m. All night prayer for our nation. Tell your neighbors, tell your friends, tell everyone. For further information, visit with us at www.churchofthefirstbornassembly.org or on Facebook. Email us at church668hope@gmail.com or call us at 753-1113 or 236-7271. Your free gifts and offerings will be greatly appreciated at Church of the Firstborn Assembly, account number 795222 at the First Citizens Bank.
Get in touch with God. Get in touch with God. Turn your radio on.
Share the line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM. The line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
At no point in time in this country do consumers exercise their right as consumers to help dictate market forces. It has always been dictated by the conglomerate corporate business sector that formed themselves in a cartel monopoly to dictate prices to consumers at all levels. Once everyone calmly pays the taxi fares that were raised, whether they agree to it or not, there is no way in hell taxi drivers going to drop that fare price when they realize people paying. Once someone realizes they can get away with something, they will continue to do so. And the same applies to business and pricing. And until people understand that, as consumers, we will never achieve best prices, and consumers will never benefit from actual market forces. There will always be a rational and a reason for increasing prices, but there will never be one to justify lowering prices. We saw it when the government took away the VAT off of certain goods and reduced VAT from 15 to 12.5%. It was expected that grocery prices would drop. What happened, and what has happened in the past, and what continues to happen, they never took off the 2.5%. Instead, they left the original price and add 12.5%. People who don't pay attention to the grocery prices would know that. And people who are easily fooled by commercialism and pump and flare, like how a lot of people get fooled with GG pump and flare and press articulations, will always be fooled and will never understand their role as consumers. It's as simple as that.
All right. You know, there's a video that has been circulating around social media with Gary Griffith's son. I don't know how many of you would have seen the video, but there's this video that has been making its rounds around social media. So first they would have put up a post of when Mr. Gary Griffith was Commissioner of Police. He would have made some comments about jobless men with gold chain. Alright? He would have put up and he would have made statements on April 6th, 2019. Police Commissioner Gary Griffith said yesterday, which would have been in the 6th of April, 2019, that wealth and properties will be held, police will be looking into the wealth and the properties of people who win gold chains, now big gold chains. So, and then somebody put up another one of the commissioner talking in on May, the 2nd of May, 2021, Commissioner Gary Griffith, and his statements about, again, young men with wearing gold chains that hang to the long gold chains. And so while people would have brought back up these stories of Mr. Griffith talking about young men wearing long, huge gold chains, and they're involving, apparently, they have to give account for these long gold chains, these big gold chains, and stuff like that. There's a video that has been making its rounds around social media with Gary Griffith's son. I don't know how many of you would have seen the video, but I want to show you the video that people are using as a point of discussion about the former commissioner's son. All right? And I'm going to show you the video now. Right, I want to show you that video now of what people are talking about. And you see why you have to be careful of what you do and how you do it and what you say, because sometimes people use things to come back to haunt you. Now, when I got the video, to me it was like an innocent video. That was my view. That the video is just an innocent video of a young man with a gold chain. And, but then when you looked at the video and you look at the statements being made by the commissioner, there are some people who would say it contradicts what he stands for. So let me show you the video before I get myself in any more trouble. So look at this video. Alright, so this is the video. I don't even want to play the song because the song is going to make us get flagged. I mean, they want to take us off of Facebook. So this is the video of the commissioner's son that is making its rounds around social media, that are allowing people to say things and question and put up past statements by the commissioner. So if you go on now, you're going to see the video, and you're going to see, you know, the young man barbecuing fish. But this is part of the video that is warranted, that people are looking at also. You know? So you had to go on the live to see the video, eh? I'm not going to describe or talk about what on the video. You have to go on the live, Street 919 FM, live, and also on YouTube to see the video. So this is a video. People have concerns. People are talking. People are wondering what is going on. People are asking questions. And then there are some people who are saying that the video and the statements by the former commissioner when he was commissioner and the video contradicts each other. So it's out there. It's all over social media. And social media is where the young people are. Right? Let me just let you know. If you don't know, social media is where our young people are. And the discussion about the government or the People's National Movement having a stronger presence on social media will determine a lot of things. I just want to say that again. Social media is where the young people from the ages of 19 to 39 or 35, that is where their life is on social media. They are on TikTok, they are on Instagram, they are on Facebook, they are on YouTube, they are on all the social media sites that you can think about. The young people from the ages of 19 to 35, they are on those sites. If you want to know anything about the young mind, you need to go on those sites and understand how the young people think. Young people are not so much involved in listening to a talk show. They'll faster listen to a blog on Instagram or on TikTok. You hear what I'm saying to you? And it is so bad that the young people who do TikTok will misinform people so badly. Really bad. And because the authorities, not on TikTok, not on Instagram, some of them not even on, they have other persons on their Facebook, they don't know how to deal with the issue or the issues that are coming up. Right? The issues that are coming up. And that some of us have, that some of the young people are facing. I'm saying that to say that the opposition, all the opposition forces understand that. I don't think MSG understand that. MSG don't have a presence really on Instagram and on Facebook and on Twitter and on all the social media. MSG is a wannabe party. Right? I'm saying that straight up. But you see the reality of the youth. I was talking to some young people on Saturday, and one young person said to me, I am not like my mother and father. The young person is about 19. Their siblings are 21. One of the other siblings is about early 20s, or well, mid-20s. We were just having a discussion, and they said to me straight up, I'm not like my mother and father. I'm not going to die anything. I'm not dying no UNC or no dying no PNM. Right? I said, so how do you get information about what's going on in the country? And how are you aware of what's happening in the country? So sometimes we get it from on TikTok, or we get it from on Instagram, or we might come through Facebook, because Facebook becoming like a dinosaur to some of them. So I said, okay. And they said that, and they played a video for me of a young lady expressing her feelings about the divers, and she believes it's a sacrifice and whatever. And one of them said to me that where they work in a bank, I'm not going to call the name of the bank, they were told that they were asked to sign the petition that over 200,000 people signed already. They were asked to sign the petition. And in being asked to sign the petition, the person who presented the petition to them were very emotional. And told them, oh, the board had to go on. Somebody had to go on. This is evil and this is wicked. And the young lady said to me that she asked her mother about it. And the mother said to her, no, don't sign no petition. Because wait until the investigation happens and then sign the petition. The mother said to her, put yourself in these people's position, in these people's shoes. Would you like for somebody to sign a petition on you who working in the bank when an investigation is going on with somebody's account? Would you like for somebody to fire you before the investigation is through? And the young lady said, no, I wouldn't like that. She said, well, it's the same thing. You know? And I'm like, wow. Okay. So, the youth of Trinidad and Tobago, as I said before, they don't listen to talk show. Most of them don't listen to talk shows. And if they do listen, to a little talk, where on the youth station, some of the presenters on the station are totally current affairs illiterate. They don't even know. Aya announcer said this morning that if you get a ticket for wearing a face mask, you wouldn't get a visa because that would be against your name. And strange enough, somebody had to message him and tell him, hey, you're feeding fake and false information. So imagine a young person listening to a youth station with an announcer saying, if you get charged for not wearing your face mask, you won't be able to get your visa. And somebody now had to message him and tell him, hey, you're off. Fake news. You're spreading wrong information. Then he had to pull it back. You understand? So that's what I'm talking about. Our youth, and Kingsley would have alluded to it by talking about social media. The youth of today are not like the youth of my time. You know, somebody said it to me on Saturday. If you really, really question some of our young people today, who are the age of 15, 16, 17, 18, I'll go as far as 18, about Mr. Patrick Mervyn Augustus Manning, most of them will not be able to tell you who he is or who he was. Most of them will not, they may say, he was a former prime minister who died. Ask them about his achievements or what was his plans for Trinidad and Tobago, and they don't know, they wouldn't know, most of them will not really be so interested in that. The youth in my era would be more aware of who Patrick Manning was. You know why? Because we would have been able to get free tertiary education from Mr. Manning. You understand? So, the youth that we're looking at, the demographics of the youth that we're looking at to vote in the next 3 years. So, I really want to talk about this because I want to draw your attention to when I had my member of parliament in the studio. He said that there are about 20,000 persons eligible to vote in San Fernando East. And the majority of those persons are youth. So the 10,000 who voted for him are people who are at the ages of, let's just say, mid-30s, late 20s, going down. And the majority of people who did not vote, which is the other 10%, are the youth who are hooked onto TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, all the other things that politicians haven't able to tap into yet. But let me just throw in this because some of you don't like when we say this, but it is a fact that what the UNC is doing is that they are trying to hold on to their base. So what they did is they tap into a radio station that have their base. And they're talking to their base. And word on the ground now is that the UNC has now capitalized and understand that social media is bigger than just blogging on Facebook. So coming on Street 919 FM and throwing things on our Facebook page and on our YouTube page to rile up people and distract people, they realize that is a strategy. You hear me? So while I would sit and talk to the youth, I would sit down and I would talk to my nephews and I would talk to my nieces. I would talk to the young people in my community. I tell you, anybody would tell you, I just talk to the youths in my community. I just talk to them. I just relate to them. I will try to relate to them and understand them. What I can't be saying as a preacher, and I don't understand the era and the time and zone in which I am operating in. And if I am saying to you, Trinidad and Tobago, that it is much more than we are losing our young persons to a lot of things. A lot of things. We are losing their interest in a lot of things. You really think a youth want to sit down and hear me talk? All this talk on a radio? No. They're not into that. You know what they're into? Little blogs. Little podcasts. And I remember talking to some young people in the UK. And one young lady who is so passionate about racism in England. She's about how old? If Miss O'Connor is on the live, she would tell me the age of her daughter. I was chatting with her daughter, a lady in the UK, Miss O'Connor. If she's listening, she would tell me the age of her daughter. Her daughter would tell me, she said, you know what, I'll do little blogs. And you see this person who texts in here? Do you see that message you're putting up there? That person who's texting on YouTube, you see that message you put up there? I and somebody had a big discussion and fallout about that. Because the reality of it is the fact. It is a fact. Young men like Curry Marcel and the young man who works in the Tunapuna Corporation, Lord, I'm trying to remember his first name, and all these young men, Viash, and all these, there are brilliant youths within the People's National Movement. Who can capitalize on the social media to capture their youth? And one of the things that Kareem and all these young people realize is that you don't always have to toe the line and agree with every single thing
to catch the attention of their young friends. So you might just disagree with something in the main and catch their attention, and then you pull them in, you rope them in with other ways of discussion. But the time is going to come, and I brought it up, and I would have used the school and the children as an example. We were very disgruntled and upset with online learning. Some people were upset with it because they believed that not all the children in Trinidad and Tobago had devices to come on to learn properly. Some people were upset with it because they don't believe that the children were properly supervised to go through the online learning. But I want to say to my nation today that we have to find a way to balance the two. Are we going to lose our children? We're going to lose them. One mother said to me, her son hated reading, never liked reading. And you know what she had to do? When he go to sleep, a therapist outside of Trinidad and Tobago said to her, put reading books on his tablet, and when he goes to sleep, put on a headphones over his ears, and he is going to listen to reading. He's going to listen. While in his subconscious, the reading is going to be going on, and you buy those said books that you put on the tablet for him. And when he begins to read the books, or when he start or attempt to read, he will realize, hey, it's like a deja vu. And he will start back into getting into the habit of reading. We have to find strategies or we will lose our children. Trinidad and Tobago. We have to wake up. So we want our young people to be politically educated. We have to find a way to reach out to them. Don't wait until it's too late, you know. Because then you will start to say they're ungrateful. All right. I think I've said enough. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you, Pastor Google, and to your listeners. Pastor Google, I cannot believe that we are still begging the PNM to step up in the PR and to step up on their presence on the social media. It appears, you know, after all you win and all you get in government, is turn off. So you can't hear nothing, no advice. We've been bawling in all the ears, PNM, to step up because they have all kind of information out there that is not the right thing. But all you do business about that, because it's not once, twice, it's not even the third time we've been telling all about all the poor PR. But as Pastor Google said, don't wait till it gets too late. But it appears like that is exactly what they're waiting for, sir. I'll leave it there. Have a good day.
Hello, good afternoon.
I just missed the ending up of what you were saying. I'm really impressed with your position that you know this part there. In terms of, you know, the therapist, the pressure. So that's a real good technique. That is a very, very good technique. You know, that's as the old man.
Whoa, I don't know what happened there. Hello, good afternoon.
Hello.
Hi.
Good afternoon. Hello.
Yes. Hello, good afternoon.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes, Pastor Google. Like I said again, Pastor Google, I think the PR or the PNR need to take a look at social media,
I'm not only talking about, I don't want people to misunderstand what I'm saying, eh? Because when you all call in and you all focus on just that alone, I'm talking about in the whole sphere of things, in education, in everything.
Yes. Of course.
We have to, we have to do it because we can't allow outside influence to educate our children and to influence our children. Once we allow that to happen, yeah, and we drop our guard where that is concerned, it influences now even the politics of the mindset of our children.
Of course, I don't forget what happened in Tobago as well. If you do result in Tobago, because people seem to be following a particular party which came on board about 3 years ago, and people follow the leaders. And look at the results of Tobago. PNM kind of lost when I was in Tobago because of the youths. So I think maybe it's time for the PNM.
Okay. I don't know what happened there, caller. You need to call me back. Hello, good afternoon.
Pastor Gogo, I hear you say you're a pastor, but you're defending evil, right?
You serious? You really want me to show a video about what is evil? You really want me to show you what is evil? Look. Yeah. Let me show you what is evil. Will you want to talk? Will you want to come on and talk crap about evil? Will you really want to go there? Or let me go there. Let us go there. I wasn't going there, you know. But let me go there. Let us go there. We're going down that I'm going in that gutter hole with you. Today I will go down in that gutter hole with you. I doesn't want to go down in gutter hole, eh? But sometimes you start to go down in some gutter hole with some of you because you all are. You all have some, here what you running into. And that's what I'm talking about, Trinidad and Tobago. So you see the statement he just made there? How I defended evil is because of a video. There are several videos out there that are talking about the incident that happened with, of course, I wonder if I didn't save that, buddy. The incident that happened with the men at Paria, and there's a young lady who did a video claiming that, you know, it was a blood sacrifice, and if you don't see it, then your eyes glued down with I did save it. I want to show you all this. You see, you don't understand that the young people, the level of craziness that's going on, you know. Some of you think that it's a joke and I just sitting down and talking to young people, and while I'm talking to them, I am being guided by them, and not seeing it for myself. So this is what I'm talking about. So Mr. Wienem Central would call in to tell me that I defending evil, but I want to show you all this. I want to just show you all what is defending evil for them. Right? I need to show you all this. So look at this. You need to come on the live, eh? Because I'm not going to show it again. I'm not even going to play the whole clip of the young lady. But I want to show you all. I need to show you all this. I need to just get this off of my vibes, boy. I'm fed up of them. I'm fed up of people like Central and the whole host of them that will take their time to come on radio to distract you. Or sometimes I don't only want to see it as a distraction, but I want to show you. Where is this? I want to show you what our young people are bombarded with. I want to show you what they are bombarded with. In the meanwhile, let me show you this video. And I'm not going to play the whole thing. I can't stomach it. I'm sorry. But I want to show you what young people, and this is a young girl, she's not even in her, I'm sure she's not even in her 30s. But I want you to listen to what she says. Look at this, Trinidad and Tobago, and listen to what this young lady is saying, and understand that this is the cue our young people are taking information from. Look at this. Me blocking all, you know. Well, you could come on the live and do all your nonsense. I don't have time. I have about 4 or 5 computers to be operating here to be blocking all you. Sorry. Look at this and listen to this.
If only you noticed by now that this diver's death was actually a blood sacrifice, all your eyes had to be closed shut. Crazy glue, gorilla glue, what's the next little thing in the little tube? thumbtacks, everything has to be on all your eyes. Because that is very abnormal. First of all, for those...
Right, so you understand, I'm not even going to play the whole video, because I'm not getting into that. But I want you to understand that that is where young people get a cue from. They would watch this video with this young lady, listen to all what she has to say in a blog, and young people will believe what she has to say because they will think that what she's seeing there, she knows what she's saying. You hear what I just say? Somebody coming on the live and saying, but she is right. So that's what I'm saying to you. People will take their cues from people who don't even know what they're saying. But you know, I'm going to show you a video that happened right here in Trinidad, you know. And the person who's saying she is right, you will not hear them talking about this, you know. I'm going to show you a video. You see me? After I show this video, I don't talk. Let me show you this video. Watch this video. Only talking about blood sacrifice? Only really serious? Only really want me to get into that stupid discussion and argument I told you? About blood sacrifice? Only serious? Only don't want me to get serious, I told you? Only ain't gonna like me, you know? Only ain't gonna like me. Watch this. And tell me, will you want to talk about paria? Hey, little girl? This happening in Trinidad and Tobago. This video I'm going to show you. And I never hear nobody talk about it. Nobody ain't talking about it. But Central want to call me and talk about blood sacrifice? Look, will you leave me alone? Watch this. And then come to me with blood sacrifice. Watch this. Watch. Come on in live. You had to come on in live to see it. I only want to talk to me. Central, you want to call me by? You serious? Can't be serious. You cannot be serious. And these are the things that our young people are seeing. These are the things that our young people are watching. And then you want to talk to me? And that's what I'm saying. We will, if we don't step up and get serious in this country, we will lose our young people to people like Central and their nonsense. Hello, good afternoon.
Hey, good afternoon, Papa G. And you're making real sense. You didn't want to show these two videos, you know. You just had us to open today's Express and watch the story on the second page. You see the story on the second page?
No, I didn't see it.
Oh, well, pull your Express and just open it. And you will know what evil is, brother. And prepare for the backlash right now. You're battling the principalities and the powers that take place. You're trying to see what we could do so that you could re-augment the consciousness of the youth which is being hijacked by these evil people telling the children one thing and coming with a next story for black people and the black people taking the chain up because they don't know the history and they don't know how to deal with the modern times in this place. If they understand, we're looking for ideas, Papaji, to help people along the way. You're trying to make it get people to blog to tell the truth, you know. No, big exciting thing. You want the energy. You want the truth out there. The truth of the chronology of the development in this country. This is how we end up, here. You call it the so-called evil. Open the Express, Mr. Central. Die evil, brother. Let's open it and read the story, the headline on that page. When you open it, the page on your right-hand side. Die way you call evil. So, there, yeah, brother.
Thank you very much. I don't know now.
Yeah, Cora, but they see now they see Pastor Google that evil pastor for the PNM. When you come and talk about that mad talk right about the PNM, doing nothing for people there, boy. Pastor Google, why you call the radio, boy? Yeah, Pastor Google, we know Raul is the biggest Obia man in this country. You see, we do manning. You boast and talk about we do manning out. We know Raul is the biggest Obia man in this country, boy.
I will say this. On social media, there are many government ministers that have a Facebook profile that people could access. And there are many TikTok videos or YouTube channels that you could go on to listen to get proper information. The problem is they don't have it, I know. The problem is the youths of today, because of the lack of how to absorb information in a proper manner, will always seem to prefer to go to look for the wrong information to run with it. We've seen it over this pandemic period, where all the topic you're getting is all the anti this, anti that, incorrect information, and the right information in front of the eyes, they wouldn't listen to it, but they're running with the wrong thing, because in this present day and time, being wrong is right. And the political oligarchs and them realize they could easily superimpose wrong information by putting a hint of truth. They will put a quarter of truth and three quarter lies, and you go run with it because you hear something that sounds good or no. But then realize that all the rest was fabrication and lies, and you run with it. Fools are easily fooled because they choose to be fooled. So it's not that the information is out there. The information is there for those who are willing to look for it and go for it. These people would go and dig a million holes just to find a wrong piece of information, just to justify their own illiterate position. This is what they do. So the right information out there for those who want it.
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Pastor. Good topic. And I want to say, don't let Central come in and spoil your topic, because we are also learning. Good afternoon to the learners and the callers. I have never heard Central give a good contribution since I know him. Let him go and listen to Sanjeet. Have a great day.
Thank you. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Pastor Gogo. How are you?
I am quiet.
Pastor Gogo, by listener, I don't know. I hear the father call just now and say the PNM ain't giving nobody nothing. What do you want? The PNM to mind the child that's crying in the background? That's your responsibility, sir. That you made that. The government is not responsible to mind you and your child. You don't get anything free. There's nothing in life that is free. And if anybody fooled you into believing that something is free, sooner or later down the years, you're going to have to pay for it. And in some instances, with your life. Now, for this madness that we're talking about, blood sacrifice, I want to find out who dragging coffin around the country? Pastor Gogo, who is this dragging coffin around the country?
PNM.
Well, it looks so, because I want to know, but if it's blood sacrifice, who doing it? Who did it? I want them to answer. You are saying it's blood sacrifice, but who do it? That just shows the illiteracy of these people, because somehow you put one and one together and get 25. You're not even getting 11, no, and say, well, look, you make a mistake. You get 25. And we have to understand what these people are trying to do. You see, the same stupidness that they did, they didn't pass the bill amendment bill or the anti-gang legislation. Look who is the first people that getting out. People who is arrested for the murder of Dana Sita Hall. So now we go understand why is a certain past AG gone in court to get removal of murder automatic no bail. Because it has some people that need to be out to free. But I would like to tell the authorities that be, maybe the Prime Minister should call an SOE, because we have a murderer for hire. It's now free because the opposition refused to do their work. And we so stupid, we allow that because of the same thing like what is just done here with this is blood sacrifice. We take all sort of stupidness and swallow it and accept it as fact instead of going and find out the real answers. Like, I heard that they say that the people was alive in the pipeline for so long. But if it is, it was now starting to decay, it takes 3 to 5 days to decay. That means if they find them on Monday, come on, die less than 5 days. They didn't start turning red as yet, right? Are you serious?
All right. Thank you very much, caller. Have a call on tolling. Hello, good afternoon.
Hey, good afternoon, Pastor Google. How are you doing?
I am quiet, sir.
Thanks for the informative show, you know. Thanks for your good work. Pastor Google, is it illegal to wear camouflage in Trinidad and Tobago?
I believe so.
Well, that picture that you put up, I was looking at.
Oh, man.
And I remember on a trip to Trinidad, I had a small little knapsack, a little pouch bag camouflage. They took it from me, and they said that was army gear. So this person is in breach of the law, you know. And there's pictures of it, and that crime should be prosecuted because Gary. He went after everybody for all kind of stuff while you're a child on Facebook for everybody to see publicly breaking the law.
Yep.
That is not a good look at all.
At all.
You know, I don't know about firearms training and thing, but I don't know where that goes, so I won't comment on that.
Yeah.
You know, but continue to do good work, Pastor Google. Thanks for taking my call.
Yeah,
Trina, take care. Everything opening back up, but still be careful and be safe. Be still around. Have a good one, Pastor Google.
Thanks for calling.
All right. You're welcome. Thank you.
Yeah, man.
All right.
I want you all to join me on Facebook and on YouTube. I took a screenshot of a statement made by one of our trolls. Persons would come on the Facebook and hurl nasty, insulting remarks at announcers and people who are on the live. People who are on the live now would see the comment, hey, she's 16 years old. The young lady that I was talking about in the UK who does the little, she does her little blogs and stuff like that. Passionate young lady. But she knows how to catch her age group, her young people. So you are saying to all you, just now Brooklyn, call me back. Brooklyn, call me back, Brooklyn. I want you all to go on the live to see a statement that was put up by one of our, they call them trolls, on our Street 919 Facebook page. You see, I would sit here. Sometimes I really don't. I could be honest. Sometimes I sit on here and I really. Anyway, let me just say that. All right. One of our trolls came on and send a message to me. And I want you all to see the message. You see, we just laugh and skin. And we stick joke for everything. You know? One of the fellas call in and he say, you know, he's one of the devils. A devil. I want you all to watch this. And you tell me what you think on Facebook and on YouTube. I learned Facebook people and YouTube people. Tell me what you think about this statement. And this statement, to me, I taking this thing serious. I'm no longer laughing off anything. I'm taking it real serious. Thanks to the 309 persons who are on Facebook right now. Right? Because I really wanted to see it. And the 329 persons on YouTube. Look at this. And only tell me what will you think about this statement. Look at this statement and tell me what you think. Show coming to a close. the show is coming to an end. But I want you all to join me on Facebook and watch this statement that was sent to me by one of the bloggers, one of the, what you call them, trolls. Watch it. Seeing it? You seeing it, Trinidad and Tobago? And by extension, the world? And while you sitting down, and you hear what you're saying to yourself, you feel the fellow who's sending me all them stupid voice note, and thinking that the UNC and these people and them, come on the live, you know, because I'm closing off the program. Come on the live and see what this gentleman or this pest sent to me on our Facebook live. Huh? What do you think? What do you all think? That's what we reach to in this country. So I know what I have to do. I don't know if you all know what all I have to do. But you see more? I know what I have to do. I good. I real good. I real, real good. Brooklyn, just now, I'm coming to answer your phone call. Hold your hand. I real good, Trinidad and Tobago. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Pastor Google.
Uh-huh.
After Google and listening, and I will tell you. You see, everything that happened in the country, Pastor Google, I see when people run in house and kill family, four, five people shot dead. You don't see the effort put in theaters when something happened in big places, like what happened with the men and them that drunk there, with the kind of people trying to kind of make that as if it's to blame the PNM why that happening. Pastor Google, I gotta tell you something. You see the game the politicians and them playing right now, especially the UNC, is not that can do nothing good for Trinidad and Tobago. The UNC can't win no election with that. Right? Pastor Google, the problem with the PNM is the fear they have for the youths, what the young people. Because I will say it again, just what you're talking about there, these things that come in play to make a PNM a better government within, to make the message come out there, the right information. The younger ones would have to be employed to do it or put in positions to do it. And that's the fear from the ones who cannot understand how to deal with the different things that happen because the technology gone to another level.
All right.
What's keeping the PNM back?
All right, I have to go. Understand? Yeah, man.
Views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the street. 919 FM.
So tonight we're celebrating. We don't break down some barriers. We don't mash up some walls. We don't put the devil in the place. So we're going to celebrate. Hey! Say, remember buddy. Remember buddy. Remember buddy. Remember buddy. Hey! Listen! He is a great God. An awesome God, a strong God, somebody greater.